George Bernard Shaw, a very renowned figure in the field of literature, the second best dramatist in English literature after William Shakespeare. Hello friends, welcome to my channel ELS, English Literature Studies with Kaur Harpreet. In today's video, I will try to give major information about G.B. Shaw in brief. So before going to his literary career, let us take a look at his early life firstly. When we talk about G.B. Shaw, his time period is 1856 to 1950, right? G.B. Shaw was an Irish playwright, critic, and political activist. He was born in Dublin. His family's poverty was a great source of frustration to him, and even his schooling was not regular. His father was an alcoholist, and therefore there was very little money to spend on his education, right? So George went to local schools but never went to university, and was largely self-taught. He cultivated music, visited art galleries and theaters. As a result, he spent most of his time reading literature. So he created his developed his we can say interest in reading literature, right? And in 1876 he joined his mother in London. As we know that his father was an alcoholist, so he joined his mother in London and he never went back to Ireland for many years. This was the time when he hoped to become a writer, and during the next 7 years he wrote 4 unsuccessful novels, right? Now he joined the Social Democratic Federation, and he was introduced to the works of Karl Marx. This is the work of Karl Marx, right? He was convinced by the economic theories of Das Kapital, a work by Karl Marx, but was aware that it would have little impact on the working class, right? And after reading Karl Marx, Das Kapital, he was in favor of socialistic ideas, and in 1884 he joined a socialist organization which was named as the Fabian Society, right? And he was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1925. Now let us have a look on his literary career. One important thing to know about his career is that he started by writing novels at first, right? And but as a novelist he was a complete failure. He wrote 4 unsuccessful novels. These are his 4 unsuccessful novels, right? These are written by him, and he started as a novelist but he was a complete failure. And after that what happened, he appeared as a dramatist. He had written more than 60 plays in his lifetime, and he was very much influenced by Henrik Ibsen. And Ibsen's reflection we can see in some of his plays also. His play Arms and the Man was one of his earliest plays, and we can say the first commercial success in the 65 plays, including major works like Man and Superman, then Pygmalion, and then Pygmalion. When we talk about this work, it was made into a movie twice, right? First time it won for G.B. Shaw an Academy Award in 1938, and later on the play was also made into a musical play which was named as My Fair Lady, and again it won 8 Academy Awards in 1964, firstly in 1938 and then in 1964. Then we have Saint John, also his most important work. He wrote many plays about political problems, right? He became the leading dramatist of his generation, and he was awarded, and because of this he was awarded Nobel Prize, right? Now let us talk about his development as a dramatist, right? Before G.B. Shaw started his career as a dramatist, the English drama had already entered into a new phase of development, right? Before his career as a dramatist, this English drama entered into a new phase of development, and the romantic tradition of the Elizabethan drama, which held the English stage for more than 3 centuries, right? It began to lose its influence from the middle of the 19th century. I'm repeating by words that Elizabethan drama, which was popular more than three centuries. It began to lose its influence from the middle of the 19th century, right? Because the English drama had already entered into a new phase of development, right? Now, at this time, it was realized that the new drama had a serious purpose to serve. Right, so the romantic wave which was prevailing at that time, or we can say the romantic tradition of the English, old English drama, was discarded. Now at this time it was discarded, and the main focus was on real and serious problems which were prevailing at that time, which were prevailing at that age. And these problems, or real problems from social life, were accepted as the themes of the new English drama, right? This was the starting of new phase of development of English drama. When young Bernard, when G.B. Shaw was young, he appeared on the scene of the English drama, right? Ibsen had been already sufficiently influenced these English playwrights. As a result, what happened? The melodramatic romanticism disappeared in favor of treatment of actual English life. And with this, we can say the theme of the drama became more and more a drama of ideas. It was not romantic ideas. It was a drama of ideas. It was filled up with ideas or real social life or problems from social life, right? Sometimes it was also didactically set forth also. When young Bernard, we can say when he came to London, this movement for the new drama, this phase of development of English drama, which was started by Ibsen, this phase of new drama or this movement for the new drama had already set in when Bernard G.B. Shaw came into the scene, right? And he at once, we can say, plunged into this movement and made himself known first as a dramatic critic and then as a dramatist. Firstly, he tried his hand as a novelist. Then he appeared as the first dramatic critic. And after that, he became a dramatist. And most of, as a dramatic critic, most of his criticism is of two types. First one is art criticism. And second is criticism of society's formulated ideas. This one is first art criticism, criticism of music, criticism of literature, painting and drama. All these are included in this art criticism. And second type is secondly criticism of, we can say, society's formulated ideas in religion, politics, etc. Right? At first, we find G.B. Shaw as a very realistic person with very much intellectuality. He can, which can be seen in many of his plays. His emphasis, firstly, his emphasis was on intellectuality, and we can see it in his many plays. If we talk about his play Man and Superman, we find him addressing life force, right? And in his play, when we talk about Arms and the Man, in which he describes about the futility of war and death in the battlefield. G.B. Shaw, he never stopped and he tried to give plays until his death, right? And later on, he was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1925. So friends, this is about G.B. Shaw as a dramatist, or G.B. Shaw's biography, his early life, his literary career. I have tried to give much information in brief time because it takes a lot of time to upload the video. So I have tried to minimize it and with maximum knowledge. I hope you will like the content, and if you like it, please hit the like button, share and subscribe my channel. And if you are new to my channel, please hit the bell button so that you can get notifications for my upcoming videos. Thanks a lot for watching.